Today we're going to look at how we can modify text in Final Cut Pro 10 to fit it into a scene. I have a photograph here. I'm going to press the X key to mark this clip. And then in the title inspector, I'm in the build-in, build-out category. I'm just going to select the fade title and press Q to connect it to this clip. I'll change the text to say summer. And I'll change the font and the size. Now, sometimes you want to be able to rotate a title in X, Y, or Z, but you don't want to work with 3D text. Well, here's a great way to do that. In the text inspector, I'm going to enable 3D text. And the reason I'm doing that, if I click on the text in the viewer, we get rotation handles that you do not have access to if the text is 2D. So now with the text being 3D, I can freely rotate it and then turn 3D back off, and I've got 2D text that is rotated on an axis. I'll undo that and bring my text down, and I want to lay it down to look like it's laying in the sand here. And then I'll disable 3D text. And we've quickly been able to orient 2D text by rotating it on an axis. Here's another example where I have some text that's the same fade-in title. I want to orient it onto this billboard. In the text inspector, if I enable 3D text, select the text, I can move it up and over, but when I rotate it, it doesn't really look quite right here. I can rotate it a little bit on this axis as well. If I hold a command key down, I can be a little more accurate, but I don't have enough perspective. I have this bottom line matching here, but the top line doesn't match. So I'm going to undo that by pressing Command-Z a few times. Another option is to use the Distort tool. However, the Distort tool fills the entire frame, so I would need to zoom way out in order to try to adjust this text to fit the space, and it's a bit of a pain in the neck, so I'm going to undo that. Shift-Z to fit the viewer back to the window, and I'll turn off the Distort tool. Instead, what I'll do is enable 3D text and move the text in Z space to fill the frame. Now, you could accomplish the same thing by simply increasing the font size. Then I'll disable 3D text. I'll go to the Transform tool and scale down the entire frame and then move it over the billboard. Now, with this smaller frame size, I'll switch to the Distort tool, and I can easily distort this text in order to fit into the frame by aligning the corners to the corners of the billboard. Finally, I'll add a move to make the shot more dynamic. I'll select both the title and the clip, press Option-G to make a compound clip, and press Return. Then select the Crop tool, select Ken Burns, and I'll reposition my ending framing and press Done. Then I'll do the same thing for the first clip, Option-G, Return, Crop tool, Ken Burns. I'll switch the start and end and reframe the ending framing and press Done. Click the subscribe button below. If you have an idea, comment, or suggestion, leave those below as well. Go to rippletraining.com for fast professional training on Final Cut Pro, Motion, and DaVinci Resolve from industry professionals.